So we were approached by the Museum Center and asked to contribute on a scientific project. They currently have this mummy exhibit going on right now, and they have a small child mummy, and they were interested in trying to figure out a little more about the situation of how the child was buried and perhaps why the child passed away.
So the first thing we took were the radiographs.
Oh, cool. Oh,
awesome.
Whoa.
So then the CT, we did the CT, which obviously gives us a lot more information. By the time we were done, I think the last number I looked at was over 12,000 images total that we were working with. We actually took the same approach to evaluating the images of this mummy that we do to evaluating the images of any child that we might see here at Cincinnati Children's Hospital. So we are a large pediatric radiology department, and within our department, we are subspecialized.
So it all sort of fits together.
Myself and Dr. Alex Tobin, we're both body imagers, so we were focusing on some of the soft tissue structure, trying to figure out gender, look at things in general. We had Dr. Ta Leor, she's a musculoskeletal radiologist, and so she was focusing on looking at the bones and trying to determine the age of the child. And then we had Dr. Jim Leach, who's one of our neuroradiologists, who's focusing on the skull structure, looking at the spine. There's several things that we were looking at on the CT, a couple of things that we had set out to try and figure out at the beginning. So the first thing was to try and figure out the age of the child at the time of death.
And the tibia, based on ossification, again, it all ranged somewhere between 1 and 3 years.
As we kind of look at the sum of the data and look where everything is kind of pointing, we believe the child was about 2 years, 6 months of age at the time of death. The other question that we wanted to try to address was the gender or the sex of the child. Our feel here at Cincinnati Children's is that this likely was a female child. This was a little girl.
This is very linear. This either looks like a fracture or something.
One thing that we did pick up when we were looking at the exam and caught our attention was there was a little hole through the spine. And this is kind of a long hole, like a tract. It went from one side of the spine to the other side of the spine. We printed a more extensive print of the mummy as well that allowed us to do sort of a direct comparison with the 3D imaging.
Once it was all printed in its 5 separate pieces, I then glued everything together and matched it up to the position that the mummy was found and is currently laying.
There's something that is unique about seeing it made.
I think with the radiologists all being able to hover around the model and look at it and touch it and spin it and see it in real life, it really helps out what they're trying to do and the information that they can gather.
The overall consensus is that this probably did represent a sampling of the mummy that occurred in some delayed fashion. What we noticed right off the bat is this child was actually relatively healthy when they died. We didn't see findings of tuberculosis, which was a cause of death in patients or in people from this part of the world at that time. We're not seeing any fractures, so we're not seeing acute fractures, so those would be fractures right around the time of death. We're not seeing healing fractures that would suggest the child had some major trauma and healed from that. We're not seeing findings that the child had something like a widespread cancer. More pieces of this puzzle will come together and get us closer to having an answer, but it's hard to say exactly, and I'm not sure we ever necessarily definitely will know how this child died.